I'm Mendeleya and Shmuel, who's your tzedis today, Lag BaOmer. And tonight we have a Zoom meeting with the whole family.
בעזרת השם שיהיה לעילוי נשמתו.
Which whole family? Your family?
Well, you know, with Shalamis and May and Nechami and Mordechai, but it's 4 o'clock in the morning. I was going to let you know.
Wow. Let me know later. We'll see. Maybe we'll get up.
Okay.
Okay, Sharon.
I'm speaking.
Oh, okay.
Shira, I have to leave at 11 o'clock, so I don't, I...
Okay.
I'll be here.
I have to also.
בסדר, yeah, we'll try to make it קצר ולעניין. Okay, so we're all in? אנחנו נתחיל? Okay, so today we're going to start a little bit on the opposite to show what, how it went. כמה שאפשר לשחזר, to recall what went when Rabbi Nachman was telling the stories. Okay? Because usually what do? We learn one little story and sometimes we learn where, you know, which pasuk where it came from. ואנחנו לא רואים את כל הסיפור שלהם. We don't see the whole story. So today we're going to work a little bit like we can try to imagine what it was around Rabbi Nachman's table when they were sitting, when he was sitting with his chassidim and they were learning Torah. And they came to the pasuk in Sefer Yeshayahu that's in the Daf Mekot at number one. ומעולם לא שמעו, לא הזינו, עין לא ראתה. Elohim zulatecha yaseh lamechakeh lo. Okay, do you all have the paper?
No, sure. Can you please tell the office they haven't been sending me the link? I've been bothering June for the last 2 weeks. I emailed them, I WhatsApp them, I called them, but so far nothing.
Because I told her, I gave her your name, May. I told her that you didn't get it, and she told me that she sent it to you. So maybe they don't have the correct email. Can you send me after the shiur your email and I'll take care of it?
Certainly, thank you.
Do you have my cell number?
No. I'll get it after because people okay. have to leave at 11.
Okay, okay. So Rabbi Nachman is sitting and learning Tanakh with his chassidim and they're in Sefer Yeshayahu, one of the nevuot la'atid lavo limot ha-mashiach, that's what it's dealing with. And they come across a pasuk gimel, what we just read, and it mentions, ayin lo ra'ata Elohim zulatecha ya'ase la'mechakeh lo. And Rabbi Nachman is trying to explain what does it mean, ayin lo ra'ata. And from ayin lo ra'ata, we have the Rashi over there, that I'll just read the last sentence, mashmo'o, אין שום נביא לא ראתה את אשר יעשה הקדוש ברוך הוא למחכה לו זולתי עיניך. There is no eye, okay, an eye of a navi that can see or that can know. How is הקדוש ברוך הוא going to compensate us? Whoever is waiting and yearning for הקדוש ברוך הוא. Okay, אין לא ראתה אשר יעשה אשר אין לא ראתה אלוקים זולתיך יעשה למחכה לו. Okay? As they're trying to learn this pasuk, and they understand that this pasuk has to do with Yomot HaMashiach, and it takes us to Masechet Brachot. Masechet Brachot, they also, they're talking about the same inyan. Okay? Look at number two for whoever has. And whoever doesn't have, I'm going to read it in Hebrew, and then I'm going to explain it in English. Okay? מהי עין לא ראתה? What does it mean, עין לא ראתה? אמר רבי יהושע בן לוי. This is the answer that רבי יהושע בן לוי is giving. What is עין לא ראתה? It refers to יין המשומר בענביו מששת למי בראשית. רבי יהושע is telling us, עין לא ראתה is referring to the wine that is in potential in the grapes that were created with creation. Okay, I'm going to continue reading it and then I'm going to explain it. Okay, לא להיבהל. רבי שמואל בר נחמני אמר, You know what? Let's not read it. I'm not gonna read it. Okay, I'm gonna save the few minutes on that. So Rabbi Yehoshua Levi says, what does it mean, Ein Rata? It means Ein Rata is referring to the wine that was in the grapes of creation. אבל מה הגדולה פה של הפרשנות? What does he mean in this פרשנות? He says that there are certain things that were created at the beginning of the creation, בתחילת הבריאה, that were created יש מאין. What does it mean, יש מאין? Like, let's say if I'm going to ask you a chicken, okay? What was created first, the chicken or the egg? So, according to this pirush, what was created first? The chicken. First chicken. It was the chicken, and then the chicken laid the eggs, and then more chickens came. But bebriat ha'olam with the grapes, first HaKadosh Baruch Hu created the grapes without planting the seeds and watering it, and only then came the grapes, okay? It's called yesh me'ayin. There was nothing, and then at the fourth day or the third day of the bria, there were grapes. And already in the grapes, there was wine, but an eye, a physical eye, I can't see this. Now, let's read number three, the Marsha. Okay, and let's see what he says about Ein Lo Ra'ata. Okay, because we have Ein Lo Ra'ata, and they're talking about the grapes, okay? The Yain HaMeshumar. Yain is wine, Meshumar is preserver.
Preserved.
Okay? So now let's see what the Maharsha has to add for us. The Maharsha says like this, Ze yayin ha-mishumar, milat yayin moral sod begimatria. So first of all, Maharsha says, if you're talking about wine, okay, you should know that wine is a secret, it's a sod. Do you remember once we learned about the wine that אחד התהליכים של היין, the most important stage of making a good wine is it has to be in the darkness and the quiet. You remember we spoke about it a few years ago. Yeah. Okay? So yain more al sod. Yain is some kind of a secret in gimat. And it's also the same letters, the same numbers in gimatria, yain and sod. ומשומר בענביו מששת ימי בראשית. Okay? And this wine is preserved for us from the day of creation. והוא רמז שאותו יין הוא דבר רוחני. He wants to tell us that wine that they're talking about, an היין המשומר, ועין לא ראתה, they're talking about something very spiritual. Okay? A spiritual, something a secret. It's יש מאין. Okay? דומה לאותן ענבים דימי בראשית, נבראו יש מאין. It's just like the grapes that were created in the creation, יש מאין. מה שאמר הכתוב, הענבים שנטו אחר כך שהם יש מאין, והיינו עין לא ראתה קודם הבריאה, אין זולת אלוקים. So in short, I want to say the Maharsha is taking us to a very secret place, okay? Some kind of a secret that is buried deep inside the creation, okay? And now, from this parshanut of the Avrashi and the Maharsha and the Gemara and all we have said, Rabbi Nachman is trying to explain what does it mean, Yain Meshumar. He wants to explain it to his Hasidim. And then he says, you know what? I'll tell you a story. And now we're going to read the story that he tells them. Okay? So let's read it. פעם אחת, נסע סוחר גדול עם עגלה מוסך חביות מלאות ביין טוב, ביין הונגרי. One time, a socher. How do you say socher in English? Not a dealer. Different word.
Merchant.
A merchant?
Merchant.
Okay. Thank you. One time a merchant was traveling with his servants on a agala, on a horse and a buggy. V'zaya mus b'chaviyot, and it was packed with many, many barrels of wine. Okay? And it wasn't regular wine, it was yain hungari. Or as Rabbi Nachman calls it, whoever knows how to speak Yiddish, it's called yain ungresher. Right? Yain ungresher. Okay? Yain hungari. And I want to just say that in those times, it was known, I looked it up and Wikipedia and in all kinds of places. And those times when Rabbi Nachman was telling the story, the Yain Ungersche was known to be the best quality wine ever. And of course, if it's best quality, it's most expensive ever. Okay? So they're traveling with the most expensive wine. It's Zenadir Limtzoto. It's mamash close to impossible to purchase this wine. Of course, it's expensive. Who has enough money to buy it? Okay? And the derech, they're on the horse and buggy, and the way is, you know, it's dark and it's cold and we're thirsty and we're hungry, and we have to let the horses stop and graze. כשהתארכה הדרך, פנו המשרת ובעל העגלה שהיו עם מועל הסוחר. Okay, they were starting to feel already very קשיי הדרך, the difficulties of the way. And they tell the merchandise, they tell him, ימים רבים אנו מטלטלים כבר עם היין הזה. Many days already we are dealing and looking after this wine. וסובלים בגללו, and we're suffering because of it. תן לנו לטעום מעט מאותו היין המשובח. Please, let us have just a small taste of this wine, so we'll know what we're working so hard for. What are we suffering for? נתן להם הסוחר לטעום מאותו היין הטוב. And he gave them a little taste, a shluk, as we would say. לאחר ימים, after this ליווי of the masa was over, okay, many days later, נתגלגל המשרת לעיר קטנה. One of the משרתים, one of the servants from this masa, he came to a little city, okay, maybe to a countryside or something, and he was sitting in the bar together with other people. למקום בו ישבו אנשים ושתו יין ושיבחו אותו מאוד, and they were saying, oh, this wine that we're drinking, this is the best wine ever. ואמרו שהוא יין הונגרי. And they even said that this was the Ungersche wine. כששמע זאת המשרת, when the servant heard that they're drinking the Ungersche wine, he said, let me have a taste, תנו לי לטעום. ונתנו לו, and they gave him a taste. ומיד אמר, אני יודע שאין זה יין הונגרי בכלל. I know that this isn't really יין הונגרי, this isn't the Ungersche wine. כששמעו זאת אותם אנשים, גערו בו ודחפו אותו. When the different people that he was drinking with, when they heard that he said that it's not Ungersche wine, they got very mad at him. Okay? Maybe they took it as an insult. In any case, גערו בו, they were yelling at him, they were telling him off, they were even pushing him, maybe even they were beating him up. והוא עמד על שלו וטען שאין זה יין הונגרי. שכן הוא היה אצל סוחר גדול, ואצלו טעם יין הונגרי, ולכן יודע הוא מהו יין הונגרי, אלא שהם לא השגיחו עליו כלל. And even though they were insulting him and beating him up and kicking him, and each story has different descriptions over here, but the bottom line is that they told him off and they told him to leave their bar. But even so, he was very sure of himself, and he told them, I know what yain hungari is because I tasted it once, and I know that this is not it. You can't make a mistake. You're not going to be able to convince me that this is yain hungari. And then the story was that he was kicked out. He was kicked out of the bar. Okay? זה הסיפור שלנו. Does anyone have questions about the story? Okay.
אין סוף לי, יש...
כן.
אין סוף לזה, לסיפור הזה.
אז תכף ננסה קצת לגלות למה... איזה רבדים הוא מכביל לנו פה, רבי נחמן. אז קודם כל, בוא נתחיל. Let's start with saying that רבי נחמן has many stories that he has סוחרים, dealers or merchants, okay? Do you remember at the beginning of the year we did a story about the merchant that comes yeah. to the city center and he leaves his servant and servant. He gets beaten up. They ask him what his name is.
Right.
I don't know, whoever remembers, that was one story about a merchant. So Rabbi Nachman has two types of merchants. Okay? שתי טיפוסי מיסוד של הסוחרים. One is a positive one. This is a merchant that comes to the city, comes to the town, and he checks, what are your needs? What can I supply? What is the best price I can give it to you? והוא ממלא, משתדל למלא את חסרונם כפי צורכם. Okay, he tries to supply all the needs. And the second kind of merchant that Rabbi Nachman talks about sometimes is not so positive. Okay, this is a merchant that he tries to get the best deal, that he can convince the Eskimoim to buy, לקנות את הקרח, to buy the ice. This is a merchant that is trying to convince you to buy what he has to sell, even though it's not what you need. Okay? He can even... סליחה, חנה?
אולי בסיפור הזה זה גם... זה לא ברור איזה אני... מה הסוף של הסיפור, למה אולי לפי רמת הבן אדם, אז אחד מרגיש שזה יין מיוחד, או השני לא מרגיש.
רגע, את כבר קופצת לסוף הסיפור.
סליחה.
בוא נראה. אז בוא נבין את זה לאט לאט. ראינו שקודם כל יש לו פה סיפור על סוחרים, ויש לו סוחר שהוא יכול להיות חיובי, וסוחר שיכול להיות שלילי. נכון? איזה סוחר יש לנו בסיפור הזה? The merchant that we have in this story, is he a positive person? Is he a negative person? What kind of a merchant is he?
Negative.
What is he?
Negative.
Negative? What makes you think that he's negative?
He's criticizing the wine without basis, just to get whatever it is he wants.
Wait, he's not criticizing.
He's saying it's not real.
No. That's the servant that you're talking about.
Oh.
Okay? אולי אני בלבלתי אתכם, I'm sorry. Maybe I used the wrong word. The servant is with the merchant. The merchant is the guy that all the wine belongs to him. He's the socher.
Ah.
Okay? And he's on the agala, and then his servants are asking him for a taste of the wine. And then he gives him to taste the wine. זה בעצם כל הסיפור שיש לנו על הסוחר. That's all what we know about the סוחר.
He's neutral. He's a neutral character.
Okay. We can accept that he's neutral or that he's okay. They ask him for wine. He gives them wine.
Yeah. He sounds positive. He trusts what he has, and he's even willing to let the people that are working so hard to understand what it is that they're working so hard for.
Okay.
Not negative at all. He sounds very, very positive. I mean,
no, Lynn התבלבלה עם המשרת. נכון, לין. Okay. As we see that the socher, the merchandise that we have over here, he can be just like June said, הוא יכול להיות אובייקטיבי כזה, בסדר. And Becky says, no, we can even see that he's trying even harder, that he believes in the merchant that he has, and he's willing to give them to taste from it. Okay, so this is our the dmut of the socher. Who can be, מה נמשל של הסוחר? Who can Rabbi Nachman be referring to as a socher? מי לדעתכם הסוחר שלנו? מה אתם אומרות?
שם?
It could be HaKadosh Baruch Hu, נכון?
Well, he was talking about Navi. He was talking about Yeshayahu. He was talking
about... It can be HaKadosh Baruch Hu. It can be a Navi. It can be a teacher. It could be the Dmut of the Tzaddik. It can also be, we're going to see towards the end of the shul, it can also be one of our inner sides. Something within us. Okay? As... זה מתחיל קצת להיות הסיפור פה. Who are the משרתים? מי יכול להיות המשרתים שלנו?
אנחנו,
עם ישראל, היהודי
הפרטי.
נכון?
Customers, is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, בואו נמשיך הלאה. What is the wine? the wine that he's selling, what do you, what would you say? מה יכול להיות היין הזה? היין ההונגרי.
אז זה יכול להיות ידע או תואר, כל מה שנכנס.
יפה, אני אקח חלק ממה שאמרת. נכון, בואו נתחיל עם דבר אחד מאוד יפה שאפשר להגיד עליו, זה ש... רגע, שכחתי רק להגיד עוד דבר אחד לגבי הנמשל של היין, של הסוחרים, שגם הסוחר השלילי, הסוחרים האלה יכולים גם להיות בתוכנו. יש לנו את הסוחר הטוב, את הסוחר הרע, נכון? אז דיברנו על הצדדים השונים, מה זה יכול להיות. I just want to add that the different merchandisers for the good and for the bad can also be different sides in us, or as Rabbi Nachman calls it, יצר הרע. Okay, a bad merchandise that is able to convince us to buy something that is not matim, that we don't need, can also be יצר הרע. Okay? טוב, בואו נמשיך. אז שאלנו מה יכול להיות היין, ואני אתחיל עם מה שחנה אומרת. היין לוקח אותנו אולי למקום של מעמד הר סיני, של קבלת תורה, שאנחנו לא רחוקים מזה, עוד שבוע וחצי, שבועיים, אנחנו כבר בשבועות, נכון? אז מה זה אומר? מה המשמעות של זה, של מעמד הר סיני, של קבלת התורה? בואו נחשוב רגע בהקשר של הסיפור, מה זה באמת אומר, אוקיי? עכשיו רגע אני אתרגם לאנגלית. What does it mean the yain, yain המשומר, yain הונגרי, that they have tasted, if we're thinking about מעמד הר סיני עם קבלת תורה? מה הנמשל של זה? יש לכם רעיון?
עניין יכול להיות באמת התורה, או כל, נגיד, ספרי קדושה, ודברים, הנשים שבתוך הבר הזה, כשהם מסתכלים על היין הזה, הם לומדים שהאיכות והעיקר שלנו זה בעצם התורה, וכל הדברים הקדושים שממנו אנחנו יכולים באמת לגלות את האמת. So they're like...
נכון, את צודקת, בואו נפתח את זה טיפה.
I was thinking of the yayin as something, all the good that's in the world, all the presence that we get from Hashem.
Beautiful, ממש מקסים. I want to build it according to מהחיצוני אל הפנים. Okay, soon we're going to, at the end of the show, we're going to get to what you said. Okay, so first of all, they mentioned here the Tawan Mamat Har Sinai. So... עם ישראל was standing in מעמד הר סיני, we got the Torah. זה היה חוויה רוחנית מאוד מיוחדת לדבר פה עם השם, right? עם ישראל was talking to הקדוש ברוך הוא, and then they got frightened and they asked Moshe to be the man that was, שהוא המגשר ביניהם. זה היה חוויה מאוד מאוד עמוקה, אמיתית, של אמת. It was a special, special... חוויה of the truth, of כאילו the closest to God that you can ever get, right? And then after מעמד הר סיני, we walked off with הלוחות הברית, with the Torah, and ever since, עם ישראל is walking with the Torah, and just like the servant, we're getting beaten up, they're killing us, they're chasing us, they're exiling us. עם ישראל הוא עם נרדף כל השנים עם התורה, זה כמו המשרת, it's like the servant, that he is getting beaten up for knowing what is the real truth of the yain הונגרי, of this good wine that he has. And it's ממש equivalent to עם ישראל. Rabbi Nachman says there's a beautiful pasuk in שיר השירים, that it's, הביאני המלך, let me see where it is exactly, soon I'll see it. רגע. הביאני אל בית היין. זה הפסוק, הביאני אל בית היין, אוקיי? אל מרתף היין של סיני. עם ישראל is suffering a lot in order to be מקיים תורה ומצוות, in order to hold on to the יהדות, in order to hold on to the יין שהם שתו בהר סיני, in order to hold on to that special thing that they had in מעמד הר סיני. All the generations, we all know what happened to the Jewish nation. אוקיי? אז זאת אמת אחת, שלהחזיק בה זה מאוד קשה לנו. It's very hard, it's very difficult, we're suffering, we're dying, we're paying a very high price for it. Okay? Just like the משרת in the story, just like the servant in the story that was exiled because he was saying that he knows what the truth is, what the real wine is. אז זה יש לנו ברובד של עם ישראל. כשניקח את זה קצת יותר פנימה, אוקיי? What happens, first of all, after you taste the wine? What happens, כאילו תנסו אתם לחשוב על איזשהו חוויה מיוחדת שהייתה לכם, something special that you had, maybe you had something, a very special tefillah, maybe something special with your spouse, with your children, a good conversation, something very, very special, something that was באמת יין משומר, as we would say. What happens after you tasted that yain meshuma? What happens to us?
You feel good inside.
You feel very good inside.
Yeah.
What else?
Good about yourself.
You take another sip.
You take another step. Ma'od. Yep. Another what? Sip. Another sip. Ma'od.
Hard to find something that can compare to that.
בדיוק. We have here two different sides. We have one side that, as everyone said, we'll take another sip. It makes us feel very good. It makes us grow. It makes us any good thing. אנחנו שמה. But on the other hand, there's something very, איך אומרים את הסקל?
Not confusing.
Frustrating.
Yeah,
okay, there's something very frustrating about it because I know what my tefillah can be, I know where I can be, אבל אני לא מצליחה להגיע לשם. I'm not able to do it again, to replicate it again. I know what a good how I solved the problem with my child. We had such a good conversation and there was כל כך הרבה הבנה והכלה. We understood each other, we were able to really get close, and I'm not able to replicate that again. אני לא מצליחה לשחזר את זה עוד פעם. There's a lot of frustration, yearning and wanting and wishing and looking and searching for to get back to that same place where it was once upon a time. יש בזה, תשימו לב, in the פסוקים, it says, from ישעיהו, עין לא ראתה, אלוקים זולתך יעשה למחכה לו. The word מחכה לו is a very Rabbi Nachman word. Rabbi Nachman talks a lot about the כיסופים וגעגוע, the yearning, the wishing to get to a certain place in life. He says that only when Shabbat comes in and you feel how much you were waiting for Shabbat and how much you were yearning for the Shabbat, even though Shabbat is already here, when you still feel the ga'agua and the kisufim, it makes your Shabbat much stronger. Okay, when you miss, excuse me?
That's what we say about Mashiach, אף פי שמתגעגע אחכה לו.
נכון, אבל רבי נחמן אומר פה משהו עוד יותר עמוק מזה. לא רק להמשיך לחכות, הוא אומר, עצם זה שאתה מתגעגע לו, זה מקרב אותו אליך. וכשזה מקרב אותו אליך, אתה עוד יותר קרוב לזה. When you're yearning, when you're missing, when you really want something to happen, when the Shabbat finally comes, then you're there in the Shabbat in a much stronger way, in a much more emotional strength, כאילו איזה חוזק פנימי כזה שעוד יותר מחבר אותך עם השבת.
זה גם יכול להיות המשיח, שירה, שכל עוד שאתה מתגעגע, אז זה מקרב אותך לגעגועים של המשיח.
נכון. הגעגועים זה משהו אקטיבי, אוקיי? To yearn for something is it's you being active, אוקיי? אוקיי, אז בוא נמשיך עוד טיפה, אוקיי? So we spoke about הביאני אל בית היין. We saw that that one way to understand this big sod that we have in the story in the yain, היין המשומר, is מעמד הר סיני, אוקיי? שזה משתלב מאוד יפה. And then, Hannah started to say, and Etty and Becky, that what else can be Yain HaMeshumar? Yain HaMeshumar can also be, I don't remember the exact words that you said, but it was something within ourselves, okay? So, בוא נפתח רגע את החלון הזה, ובוא ננסה להבין את זה קצת יותר. So, we gave an example of, knowing something good that we were able to accomplish, and how, and it keeps us there, it stays within us, and we're always yearning to get to that place, okay? אנחנו כל הזמן, זה איזשהו מכוון, it's like a magnet that is pulling us towards it, okay? And now I want to open up over here what the midrash that I brought you, in number 5, okay? It's a very long midrash, and I cut it short, so then I'm gonna okay? There's a very famous midrash that tells us that there's a lot to learn how the fetus sits inside the womb. איך הרבה אפשר ללמוד מצורת התנוחה של העובר ברחם של האימא שלו. אוקיי? אתי, למה את מחייכת?
It's pronounced womb.
Sorry. What did I say? Sorry.
Sorry.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. That I remember the two words, fetus and womb. I just... זה לא קורה לי הרבה לזכור הכל במכה. קיצור, העובר במעי אמו. Okay, so there's a lot of דרשות of חזל that explain to us why is it so important to know how the fetus is sitting inside. מה זה משנה? There's no חידוש in it. You're not telling us something new. So why does Chazal take its time and the place in the Gemara to sit and write about exactly how he sits with his hands on his head and his feet and all that? So Chazal explained that the way the fetus sits, this is the way, there's much to learn about how we're supposed to live our life, okay? So the Midrash that I brought over here starts to explain it, but I didn't bring everything inside because I want to get to the bottom line, okay? דרש רבי שם אליי, למה הוולד דומה במעי אמו? What is it like when the fetus is inside the mother's womb? Womb?
Like yeah. Living womb.
למה הוא דומה? What does he look like? What does it seem like? It seems like a pinkas, like a little pad, okay? שמקופל במעי אמו, it's like a pad. A pad that is folded up inside the uterus. Vener daluk lo, and now they have the whole explanation of where are his hands and where is his head. His head is down to his knees.
How do they know that? How did they even know that?
They didn't have smart. They were chazal.
Chazal.
They didn't have madim in utero pictures. Wow.
זה מדהים, נכון? זה מדהים. ונר דלוק לו על ראשו, and a candle is lit over his head, וצופה ומבית מסוף העולם ועד סופו. And he can see from one side of the universe to the other side. ואין לך ימים שאדם שרוי בטובה יותר מאותן הימים. And the bad news is that these are going to be the best days in our life when we're inside our mother's womb. אוקיי? אין לך ימים שאדם שרוי בטובה יותר מאותן הימים. ומלמדים אותו כל התורה כולה. And they teach him the whole Torah. אוקיי? וכיוון שבא לאוויר העולם, and right before he's about to be born into this world, בא מלאך, an angel comes, וסותרו על פיו, אוקיי? וסותרו על פיו, ומשכחו כל התורה כולה. And he makes him forget everything that he learned. שנאמר לפתח חטאת רובץ ואינו יוצא משם עד שמשביעין אותו. And this is a pasuk. And I just brought the ending of the midrash because it's beautiful. ומהי השבועה שמשביעים אותו? What is the promise, the pledge that that this little fetus has to promise, has to make a pledge ומשביעין אותו, תהה צדיק, you should be a צדיק, ענת בי הרשע, ואל תהי רשע. ואפילו כל העולם כולו, and even if the whole world will be saying that you're a צדיק, you should always think of yourself as a רשע. Okay? I'll just say a few words about the last sentence. Okay, why should a person think about himself as a rasha? That is so negative, that is so not positive thinking. Why do they want to tell us such a bad thing that we should think of ourselves as a rasha? So I just want to say,
yeah, to be humble, not rasha.
That's right. Right. But I think it's referring to, don't believe what everyone tells you. כל העולם, ואפילו כל העולם כולו אומרים לך צדיק, even everyone is going to tell you, you're a צדיק, what's going to happen if they tell you that you're a צדיק? You're going to feel that you can let go. And what happens if everyone tells you that you're a רשע? You're going to feel that you're so bad, you may as well let go. So what do they want you to think? And this is, זה קשור, I think we learned this midrash once, and שלושה ספרים פתוחים לפני הקדוש ברוך הוא, ספר של צדיקים, ספר של רשעים, וספר של בינוניים. And a person should always see himself as a בינוני. Always think of yourself in a positive way, of course. Not that you're a רשע, but that you always have a way to do. Just like a רשע has to work a lot in order to להתקדם בחיים שלו, בעבודת השם שלו, we should see ourselves as בינוניים, that we always have work to do. תמיד יש לאיפה להתקדם ומה לעבוד. Okay? So אני אעזוב עכשיו את הסוף הזה של המדרש, but I want to go back and say that הקדוש ברוך הוא, when he, אני אנסה, I'm going to try to put everything together that we learned over here, okay? That הקדוש ברוך הוא, at the beginning of the creation, we are part of creation. בן אדם הוא חלק מהטבע. And just like הקדוש ברוך הוא created the grapes with the wine inside them already, but no one can see it, and no one can see the fetus inside the womb. אף אחד לא רואה את זה, עין לא ראתה. No one really knows what's going to be, right? No one knows what's going to be in ימות המשיח. No one knows what's going to be לעולם לעתיד לבוא. אף אחד לא יודע בשורה התחתונה. So they're asking, so how am I going to go through this world? איך אני אתנהל פה בעולם הזה? How am I going to know how to be a tzaddik and a benoni and work on myself? מה אני אעשה? Okay? And then the Midrash comes and tells us something beautiful. And this is what Rabbi Nachman is telling us about the Yain HaUngari. The Midrash tells us that in inside of each and every one of us, there's already like a little mapah, a map, okay? A map of our life that tells us where to go, how to go, what to do. הוא מספר לנו את הדרך שלנו פה בעולם הזה. Before neshama is born into the world, the neshama knows the tikkunim that she has to do. The neshama knows already what is her way in life. Kol ze yesh lanu kmo yayin meshumar, kmo yayin ungari inside us. Aval ma ba'aya shelanu, that we don't know how to reach inside to the yayin meshumar. Nachon? Kol achat meitanu yesh la et ha'mapa hazot bifnim, אבל איך אני אקרא את המפה? איך אני אדע את זה? So רבי נחמן says משהו מאוד 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 יפה. רבי נחמן uses a lot of פסוקים מבשרי אחזה אלוקה, from תהילים, כל עצמותיי תאמר נשירה, is also from תהילים. רבי נחמן says, our body knows the way. Listen to your body. Listen, be tuned inside. We use it a lot when we say, like my stomach is turning upside down when I think about what's going I have a friend, it's just a sipur tari kaze, of a friend that her son is getting married, and she tells me that her stomach is turning upside down. She feels that something is not good over there. Our body is indicating, we can use our body להבין את הדברים האלה. רבי נחמן has a lot of thought that talks about the body that's complaining, that our neshama is constantly in contact with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Our neshama is davening, is learning Torah, is conversing with people, we're doing mitzvot, but what about the body? The body complains, I also want to be part of this. So this is one of the hizdamniyot that Rabbi Nachman says that our body can definitely take a part in connecting to the Kadosh Baruch Hu in this kind of way. What is the problem? A lot of times we try to listen inside and we try to rely on our instinctim and what our body is feeling. אבל זה מזייף. זה מזייף, because יש לי בלגן גדול בפנים. לא תמיד אני מצליחה לשמוע את הקול של האמת, אני שומעת רק את הבלגן שבפנים. I'm not always able to really be tuned in to the truth that's inside me, and I'm actually hearing different things that are going inside. As soon, I'm just looking at the clock. In a few more minutes, I'll tell you what the mapitoron is, before 11, okay? אבל קודם אני רוצה רק להדגיש את הנקודה הזאת, that Rabbi Nachman says that the yaina ungari that we have, that we all drank the yaina ungari. Rabbi Nachman says something very nice. He says, I'm going to read it to you from the book. He says, לעתיד לבוא, ינסו להטעות אותנו. אזי לאחרים יוכלו להטעות ויתנו להם יין סטרוויצ'ר. It's just a regular wine, not the real yaina ungari. We're going to always, during our lifespan, we're going to always be, נצטרך לעמוד על האמת שלנו. We're going to always have to know what is the taste of the real wine. Because during the life, כל הזמן מנסים להטעות אותנו ולבלבל אותנו. We get confused. Okay? We think that it's the right thing. It's not really the right thing. It can be the right thing. Maybe it's the right thing. During our life, there's a lot of סוחרים, a lot of יצר הרע that try to confuse us. Okay, and take us to a different place. And Rabbi Nachman says, but whoever tasted the yayin ha'unbari, אבל לאנשי שלומנו לא יוכלו להטעות, כי אנחנו טעמנו את היין הטוב. Whoever was at present at מעמד הר סיני, all the נשמות בעם ישראל, will never be confused, because we're going to always know what the truth is. Okay? זה מה שאומר Rabbi Nachman. והמהר"ל אומר משהו מאוד יפה, that I'm going to read to you from here, okay? יש משהו מאוד מנחם ומעודד למה שהוא אומר רבי נחמן. רבי נחמן says, don't worry, because you tasted the yain ha'ungari, you're going to always know when you're going to come across it again. לא יצליחו להטעות אתכם, they won't be able to confuse you. And המהר"ל says something very beautiful about this midrash. He says, על כן מלמדים אותו את כל התורה כולה. He's talking about the fetus inside the mother's womb. Sorry. Okay? He says, why do they teach him the Torah? על כן מלמדים אותו את כל התורה כולה, ומראים לו את כוחה העצום של נשמתו. They show him the כוח עצום, את כל העוצמה, all the... maybe you could say potential... the potential of his neshama, okay? Why? Ba yistaya le'achar tzeto le'avir ha'olam. After the baby is born, okay, he's going to need to use everything that he learned, that he knew inside, in order to go through this life. Okay? Now, in the last 4 minutes, I want to say, כאילו, מה הפתרון? יפה ש... there's a big problem here. The truth, we have this yain משומר inside us, but how do we get there? Lo and behold, ממש משמיים, today in ספירת העומר is הוד שבהוד.
הוד.
Okay? I want to say במקרה, אבל לא במקרה, הכל משמיים.
Hey, what does that mean? What does that mean?
Hod is Sfirat HaHod. Do you remember yes. that we said that we have 7 different Sfirot? And every day we take one Sfira and we test it in the context of the other big Sfira of the week. Every week is one Sfira, 7 days for a week, 7 weeks. So every week is a Sfira. So the Sfira of this week is Sfirat HaHod. Okay?
Which means?
And every day is a different Tat Sfira inside the Hod.
What does hod mean?
Okay, hod means, hod is a Hebrew word, is the shoresh hei vav daled. Very interesting that hod doesn't have many different meanings. Okay, there are three basic meanings in Imani Lo Toa. We have hod, milshon lehodot. Okay, lehodot is milshon todah, to say thank you. We have hod, milshon hoda'ah with the aleph, means to lehodot, ani modeh she. I need a better word in English.
Acknowledgement.
Yeah, that's a good word. Okay, hod milshon to acknowledge something. We have hod even with the ayin at the end, hoda'ah. Hoda'ah is
information.
Meida, hoda'ah, okay? Yafe. What does it mean, hod shebahod? So, hod shebahod means that this day of the week of Sfirat Ahod, we are looking inside of us, and this is our opportunity להודות בפני עצמנו על כל הדברים הטובים והרעים שיש לנו. What does it mean to look inside and to acknowledge all the good and bad that we have? A lot of times we are afraid to acknowledge the bad things, mistakes that we make, even to ourselves. Automatically say, no, it's his issue, it's his problem, it's not really me. And then we don't even acknowledge to ourselves that we made a mistake or that we could have done better. So the first level of hod shebahod is the acknowledgement even to ourselves that we made a mistake or the acknowledgement that we got a lot from a Kadosh Baruch Hu. Okay? So that's the one and the first very basic of hod shebahod. The second thing is, let's say I acknowledge that I made a mistake. To go to my friend, to any person who it was that I made this mistake, ולהודות בפניו that I made a mistake, זה דרגה שנייה. Okay, this is a higher level. The first level was to acknowledge that I made a mistake. The second one is to go to my friend and to say, I made a mistake, I asked for forgiveness or whatever. Okay, this is the second level. The third level is to say Toda l'Kadosh Baruch Hu that I made the mistake, because now I can learn how to be a better person and not make this mistake again. The more we acknowledge ourselves, ככל שנהיה יותר במודעות ונתבונן פנימה ונראה את הטעויות שלנו ונודה בהם ונודה עליהם, המודעות שלנו תתחדד. How do you say מודעות? Self-consciousness? Eti? מה אתם אומרות?
Self-awareness?
Okay, yeah, that's a good word. So Chazal tell us that the more we'll be able to be in those three different stages of the Hoda'ah, Hod Shebahod, our self-awareness will get higher and higher, or maybe deeper and deeper. And the more our self-awareness can get deeper, then we can really be tuned in on our instincts, on our inner map that we have inside us, on the Yayin HaMeshumar, on the Yayin HaUngari that we have within ourselves. ככל שבן אדם במודעות גדולה יותר ועמוקה יותר, יש לו יותר גישה פנימה אל תוך היין המשומר שבתוכו. אל תוך הסוד הזה שנמצא בתוכנו. אוקיי? The Magid Mezrich also says something very nice. He says that even though there are four different worlds, each one is higher than the other, and there is such a long way for the Jewish person to do in this world and in his self-awareness and Avodat Hashem, because he's a Jew, because he has already this inner map in self him, he should, even just wanting to get there, even just yearning to learn my inner map, the directions of my life, just the yearning, רק הכיסופים והגעגוע למקום הזה, הוא כבר מתחיל להתגלות בפנינו. Even just yearning to get to that place will start revealing itself to us slowly. Okay? So Rabbi Nachman is in this short little story that he tells us, we can take it in many different directions. Of course, I always like to take it to the direction of what can I learn from here for myself, for my life. And we see that Rabbi Nachman, first of all, mamash me'oded otan, when he tells us that every one of us has this yain meshumar inside us. We already have it built in, okay? Ze chelek integrali mitochenu. The second thing that he tells us, that just like the servant was beaten up and he had to work very hard for the yain meshumar, and he had to go all over the world and it's very, very expensive, we have to understand that this is what expected of us. We're gonna have to work very hard for it, okay? Don't be frustrated, don't pick up your hands, don't say then forget it, but always know it should be like a magnet for you that is gonna always be pulling you towards it, okay? And how can we even take active steps towards the Yayin HaMeshumar that's within us from the day that we were created and that when we were a fetus in our mother's womb? Al yaday ha'todah ha'pnimit shelanu, by saying thank you. By saying thank you to Hashem that I made a mistake and learning from that. Okay? By telling my friend that I made a mistake. By la'iz listakel pnimu v'la'agid, I made a mistake. Okay? זה המתנה של ספירת העומר בשביל רבי נחמן, והסיפור שלנו פה היום, זה המתנה שלנו היום פה. Okay? זה ספירת העומר ההוד שבהוד. Telling us that this is the way to work. Okay? To acknowledge our mistakes, to bring them to our friends or whoever we have, מול מי שעשינו את הטעות הזה, our children, our friends, our family. And then thanking HaKadosh Baruch Hu for this mistake, because from there we can only go higher and higher. And when we go higher and higher, we can reveal more and more of the inner Yayin Meshuma within us.
Thank you.
Okay. So 11 and 4 minutes. I'm sorry if we're at to leave at 11. I'm sorry for being late. Slicha mikulam.
No.
Miyuchot shel Rabbi Nachman lehayom. וממש, זה ממש בסייעת הדשמיה שזה בדיוק, לא תכננתי את זה. ממש, היום בבוקר קמתי מוקדם ואמרתי, אני אקדים את היום כבר ונראה מה זה הוד שבהוד. ורק בשיעור פתאום אני מחברת את זה, אז זה מאוד מרגש אותי. תודה רבה לכם.
תודה רבה.
תודה רבה.
לג בעומר שמח. לג בעומר שמח and take care of yourselves.
You too.
Take care of yourself.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, bye bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
No.